This is ABC.
Thank you, Chantel. It's 13 minutes after the hour, and continuing with the discussion of overall Christmas decorations. No flower, of course, quite makes the point that it's Christmas, like a poinsettia. And this morning, Ralph Snodsmith, our gardening editor. Actually, you visited what, the largest poinsettia ranch?
900 acres of pure beauty. And I thought I died and went to heaven.
Yeah?
Let's take a look, by the way.
Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you.
While the poinsettia was discovered in 1825, it wasn't a Christmas tradition until almost a century later. Inspired by the fact that the plant bloomed in December, a Californian named Paul Ecke decided to make Christmas and the poinsettia one and the same.
In 1920, you decided to take your plants and go on the road. You actually got on a train and went across country?
I did, to call on prospective customers.
How'd you put a poinsettia in your suitcase, or did you carry some with you?
I carried sample plants, dormant plants with me.
You carried them on the train?
On the train.
That effort took root and spread through three generations of his family. Paul Sr., now in his 90s, has turned the reins over to his son and grandson. Just about every poinsettia can trace its origins back to their ranch in Encinitas, California.
We ship many millions of cuttings to commercial flower growers and greenhouses all over North America, Western Europe, and some to China, and just recently to mainland China.
At this point, people can have poinsettias as they please. The Eckes have developed some 25 varieties.
We have a few of this yellow type now available and ready for the market, as well as this rather peppermint type that might be called Magnolia Blush.
And for those whose thumbs never will be green, there is even a pint-sized self-watering version.
It's easy to get a new one. It's a little bit more difficult to get one that's going to be an improvement.
The Eckes have found that Christmas is a time for tradition and that their first idea was their best idea.
Red is still by far the most popular colors. 90% of the poinsettias we sell are red. And I think that that is the way it's going to be for quite a long time.
Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you.
The Paul Ecke Poinsettia Ranch out in California, that's quite a place. Nobody on horseback, though, riding around with ropes in it.
Didn't see one person on horses, but let me tell you, I saw a lot of poinsettias.
Now, when you go to the flower store, as you do, and I do, and there's 8 million of these, how do you tell one from the other? Which is a good one to get?
There are many poinsettias available this year, from these great, huge, gorgeous red ones to white and white and pink to Jingle Bells, which is a new variety, by the way, this year, which is kind of modern looking, plus a traditional pink one too. But when you go to the shop, if you have them in a sleeve, and the sleeves, by the way, in the northern areas are very important because that keeps them from getting cold on their way home. They don't like a chill. As soon as you get them home, what you want to do, if there's foil on the pot, and most of them come that way, take your finger and actually tear the foil so that you have proper drainage. If you left the foil on undamaged and you watered it, which you have to do, your poinsettia must be kept slightly moist all the time. It'd be overwatered and nothing flat. They're very easy to grow. They make great houseplants. Keep them in filtered, bright light. Keep them slightly moist. Never set them on top of the television, by the way, because that's one of the hottest, driest areas, and just back off and watch them grow.
And they are beautiful things. Ralph Snodsmith, thanks very much for
being here. Happy holidays.
All right, and same to you.
You bet.
KGTV San Diego. Now, Michael Tuck, Carol LeBeau, Captain Mike's Weather, Larry Sagnoff on sports. This is San Diego's news leader, 10 News at 5.
You see them everywhere this time of the year. Poinsettias, the plant that means Christmas, of course. But without the right treatment, they won't make it to New Year's.